Hi viewers, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the roles and the functions of a nurse. Okay, so as a nurse, what is our role and responsibility in taking care of patients in the clinical areas, like how we will manage patients, families and the community areas? Okay, so we have lots of roles and responsibilities when we enter into the clinical area. So the major areas can be categorized into these topics. Okay, so you read these major areas, like in case if you want to have a subdivision in these areas, you can do it by yourself. Okay, so I will tell you the major areas of the responsibilities of a nurse. Okay, so the first area is a caregiver. Okay, the primary, already we had discussed in the previous classes, the primary role of a nurse is giving care for the patient with lots of love and affection. Okay, so you must follow your ethical principles in giving care for the patients. You must have sympathy, empathy, all these things to be used on the patients and the family members when you are providing nursing care. Okay, so when you are giving nursing care, how you have to be responsible. You must see, in case if you are giving medication, you must know the 5 principles of giving medication, that is like during administration of medication, your 6 rights you have to remember. You have to know the drug, how you are, the action of the drug, the indication, the side effects, everything you must know regarding the drug. You must know the dosage of the drug. Sometimes the medical team, maybe by mistake, they would have subscribed different dosages. Maybe instead of 500, they would have mentioned 5000. So it is like you must have knowledge regarding the drug, so you can have a suggestion with the doctor. Is it so, doctor? You have written 5000. Is it like this? Am I asking you a wrong question, whether it is 500 or 5000? Okay, so it is by mistake, nobody does it voluntarily. Maybe it is like they are in an urgency, they would have done a small mistake. So unless and otherwise we have knowledge regarding that particular drug, only we can ask. Okay, so the knowledge level of the nurses must be adequate. So you must be adequately knowledge so that you can ask a doctor a question, that is like when, in case if they do a mistake. Okay, so caregivers, you have to take care of the patient politely, lovingly, like it is like with lot of affection you have to take care of the patient. It's not like like very rudely taking care of patient, with lot of love and affection. So politely, so whatever you want to tell, tell it slowly, humbly. You have to whatever you tell, they will obey you, unless you know the method of telling. Okay, so if it is a great procedure, painful procedure, definitely, maybe it is a lumbar puncture, definitely it's going to pain. So in case if it is a labor, definitely it is going to pain, but you must know how you have to tell. So in case if it is a labor pain, okay, so if you go and tell like ipdi da valikum, okay, so you will have pain like this, if you go and tell them, what they will do? They will also be rude, they will not cooperate with you. So what you have to tell? You have to tell them politely, okay, see, this labor pain has just started, you are going to have more severe pain like this. Okay, so now when you are screaming and when you cry, from now onwards you will become very tired, you will not have adequate energy during your final stage, that is like when you are pushing your baby, you will not have adequate energy. Or otherwise, if you tell that the baby is going to be endangered in case the lady is going to scream and yell in the labor rooms. Okay, so at that time you have to make the patient understand. So provide care according to the need in a polite and humble way. Okay, then comes the communicator. Okay, so communication is a very great task in your clinical area, where communication plays a very, very important role. So already I said, like, you will be studying, you will be knowing about the particular disease, particular medicine, particular procedure, everything you will be knowing, but the patient doesn't know anything. Now only the patient knows the pain and the suffering what they are having, okay. But we know everything and we know how to compromise that pain and suffering, okay. So you being a good communicator, you will be able to come down with the patient's pain and suffering in case if you are going to communicate with the patient nicely, okay. So you have to give adequate counseling to the patient that the pain will come down, the drug is going to act like this, it is going to react like this in your body, these are the side effects going to happen in case if you are going to have a heavy dose, all those things you can explain the patient. So maintenance of interpersonal relationship with the patient is a very, very important task which can help the patient heal much better than normal healing, okay. And then comes the teacher. So what does a teacher role? A teacher teaches the student. Likewise, a nurse is going to teach the client regarding the disease condition, regarding the prevention of that particular disease, regarding the promotion of health, regarding the prevention of illness, regarding like how to handle when there is pain, how they can have a diversional therapy, all these things you can teach the patients. The importance of nutrition, prevention, everything you can do, okay. So the nurse plays a major role in health educating or teaching the client regarding the disease, prevention, promotion of health and the maintenance of wellness, okay. And then comes the nurse advocate. Okay, so nurse is playing a major role of an advocate in the clinical area. What does she does? Okay, the nurse knows the ethical things which can happen in the hospital and what the nurse can help the patient out. Okay, so for example, maybe if a male doctor is going to examine an unmarried young girl, okay, so it is definitely there must be a female staff with the patient during assessment. So it is an ethical rule, okay. So she knows, the nurse knows, the patient doesn't know. So now she is working as a client advocate where she knows the right and wrong inside the hospital. Okay, so she can do that. And then comes the if it is an unmarried girl, she cannot undergo an PV. So pervaginal examination cannot be done for an unmarried child, a small child. You cannot do a pervaginal examination for an adolescent girl. All these things they will know. So what, when you people are working in the clinical area, you have to work as an clinical or the patient advocate. You have to support the rights of the patient, which is good and bad. You have to explain the patient and you have to protect the patient from dangers. See, you know drug toxicities. So tell the patient, so taking this much amount of painkiller is not good for health. It is going to harm your kidney. Explain that. So you are going to work as an advocate for the patient. And then comes the role of a counselor. Yes, so we are going to act as counselor. So when there is a problem, you are seeing the problem directly. When there is a confusion with the disease, they don't know how to face a disease, you know the course of illness, how it is going to be treated. Dengue, no platelet, platelet count is very less. So what you will do? You can give counseling to the patient. You can tell these type of diet they can take. Take papaya juice. Okay, so that is very good. It can improve your WBC count. So you can give them like your papaya leaf is going to increase your platelet count. So there will not be any bleeding. So you can be safe. With this, you can take this type of diet. So this is not going to communicate with the other members of the family. All these things you can explain the patient. So you can work as a counselor in helping prevent or to improve the wellness of the patient, okay? And then comes the change agent, okay? So you are going to become a change agent, okay? Sometimes what happens, the patient comes inside a hospital, psychologically upset, like depressed, sad, and all those things. You are going to become a change agent. Make them positive. Tell them there are hopes to survive. There are a lot of medical technologies. There are a lot of investigations. There are a lot of medications which can improve your health condition. So these things can give a lot of hope on the patient. They can survive. All these things, you are going to create a positivity with the patient, which is going to improve the health of the patient. Okay. So then comes the leader. So the role of a nurse as a leader is very, very important. So she becomes a leader for the other nursing team members, like where she can help to improve the patient's health conditions. Okay, so she can become a leader in different areas, like she can place people in helping the client's health. Okay, she can help out to rule out and to treat diseases in a very healthy manner. Okay, and then we have case managers. You are a case manager in the sense like you are going to deal a case. So sometimes like I will be assigned with the cancer patient. So I must know how to handle a case with chemotherapy. I must know the side effects of chemotherapy. I must know the side effects of radiation and what I have to do in case if they are going to get these types of drug. What is the effect of these drugs on the body of the patient? And what is the next step? All these things I will be knowing, and I will act as a case manager in handling the patient. So I know how to divide the job and give. So these type of maybe it is a trained nurse. I know whom to assign for the checking vital signs, whom to assign to provide a sponge bath, whom to assign a role of giving medication. All these things I know how to take care of the patient. Okay, then comes the manager in the sense your general manager, like how do you take care of the wards, how do you handle your A&M nurses, how do you handle the infection control department, how do you take care of the biomedical department, your housekeeping department, how to manage all these departments. So you are going to take the role of a manager in managing all these different areas. Okay. So finally, you have the role of a researcher. Okay. So as a researcher, you will be helping the society to rule out new diseases, to prevent new illnesses, like which drug is more effective than the other type of drug, which is having a lot of complication. All these things you will be able to rule out when there is a researcher role. Okay, so you will be able to rule out diseases, and you will be helping the society to prevent these type of diseases in future. Okay, so with this topic, you have learned about the role and functions of the nurse as your caregiver, communicator, leader, teacher, client advocate, counselor, change agent, manager, case manager, and researcher. Okay, so in case if you have any doubts regarding the subjects, kindly give your comments in the comment box. See you in the next class. Till then, bye.